Hi, what's up everyone? Welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to another episode of Sara's Honest Reviews. And for today, we are reviewing the Debashree Beauty Define Eyeliners. Debashree Beauty is a new brand on the market by the beauty creator Debashree Banerjee. So I'm so excited to be reviewing her products because she is a beauty YouTuber. And I think it's very rare for us to see beauty YouTubers in India or beauty creators in India to come up with their own makeup line. I'm very excited. I have four of their eyeliners today here with me. I have purchased all of this with my money. This is not a sponsored video and neither is this PR, but anyway, on this channel I keep all my reviews very honest. So before we dive into this, if this is the first time you've come onto my channel, then hi, I'm Sara. I make beauty and lifestyle content here on YouTube. I try to keep my content very honest and relatable. So if this is the first time you've come onto my channel, then please make sure to hit the subscribe button and join the Sara squad, and also click the bell icon right next to it so that every time I upload a video, which is Tuesday, Thursday and Sunday, you get notified. And with that, let's dive into today's review. So like I already mentioned, Debashree Beauty is the beauty line of the beauty creator Debashree Banerjee. It's a completely vegan, cruelty-free and made in India makeup company. So kudos to her for that, because all of that is very difficult to get done in India. Especially, she did all of this during the lockdown period. That was really commendable. And the first product that they have in their makeup line is something very unique. I found it very unique on the Indian market because I personally have not seen anything like this. These are basically water-activated colored eyeliners. So we usually see colored eyeliners, what we see like 4 to 5 shades in NYX, we see them in Lakme, those are the companies that come on the top of my head, but the maximum you'll get is like 4 to 5 shades. And she went ahead and came out with 15 shades of water activated colored liners. Now I keep saying water activated because that's how you're supposed to use them. First, let's dive into what they look like externally. So this is what the unicotin of the eyeliner looks like. It is very sleek matte black, and it has some lines, colored lines drawn over it, which gives the resemblance of how the eyeliners look. It says hashtag Debashree, which is the brand logo, as well as D/Fine, which is how she's labeled the product. So it's Define, and then all the names of the eyeliners, of the 15 eyeliners, are also according to that. So this is all there is to the unicotin. Very sleek, very slim and very minimalistic. I really like the external unicotin, and inside you get this eyeliner pot. It's a plastic packaging. There are all the details mentioned over here. There's also a swatch with the name of the eyeliner inside. So this is a yellow shade, and it has Delicious written inside, and behind this you have the vegan, cruelty free, made in India, and the brand logo again. So it's a very minimalistic but wholesome packaging. Packaging wise, I think it's perfect. Inside there is also a filter which is present, which I've currently removed because I was using it. It's something like this. Basically, because these are water activated eyeliners, this will help you use it to its maximum potential. Honestly speaking, I don't use it, so I discarded it, because just using it inside this is enough for me. I did use it a little bit today while I was doing my yellow eyeliner. I will get into the tutorial of this look as well ahead in the video, so you can stay tuned for that. Internally, they have this hashtag imprinted on the eyeliner pot, which I really like because it is very true to their whole branding. Now let's dive into the formula of these products. So I have 4 shades right here with me. I have this yellow shade, as well as this neon orange, this bright red color, as well as this very bright pink shade, which is on my eyes again today. So I have a mix of this yellow as well as this pink going on my eyes. I will dive into each color in depth, but first let's talk about the general formulation. So I have these 4 shades because they were sold as a bundle. This was a bright dapper bundle, if I'm not wrong, which had all these bright colors. So in the 15 shades, she has an amalgamation of a lot of colors. There are pastels, there are bright colors, there are some white and black basics. So there's a lot of shades for you to select from according to your need, according to what you want to dive into. There is not a huge market for that in India. We don't really have that many options to select from, so it was very refreshing to get such a wide option to choose from. You know what I want, I can exactly go for that, and I went for brighter shades because this is something which is more my vibe. So I went for this bundle. This bundle as a whole costed me about 2,800 rupees roughly. Each eyeliner individually retails for 800 rupees, and you get 8 grams of product in each of the eyeliner pots. So now talking about the formula of these eyeliners, how you're supposed to basically use them is you're supposed to take like an eyeliner brush, something like this, a very simple felted brush. This is not even a branded brush. I just have this from Amazon. And then you have to dunk it in water and then put it in the eyeliner pot. The amount of water you take really matters to the consistency of the product. So this is something that you have to keep in mind when you're using these eyeliners, that you might not get it right in the first place. Like when I used it for the first time, I realized that I was using way too much water, which is why it did not show up on my eyes very bright and did not look very pigmented in the first place. So using less amount of water. In fact, you don't even need like water, you just need a wet brush, like using like a wet painting brush, and just like a little bit of wetness is enough to activate the color pigment in the eyeliner, and then you can go over the eyes with it. Personally speaking, for the first time, I did not like how they sat on my eyes because I was using way too much water. So the amount of water you're using plays a very big role in how these eyeliners are going to show up on your eyelids. They might look very pigmented if you're using very less water, which is ideally the situation. But if I used too much water like the first time, then they are going to look very watery, they'll bleed, and they'll not stay on for very long. Now, pigmentation wise, I feel like they are not evenly pigmented amongst all of the eyeliners. Like the yellow shade right here is very pigmented. It's one of my favorites amongst the four that I got, because immediately as soon as I put it in the pot and put it on my eyes, it showed up, it looked bright, very popping, and also sat and dried up really beautifully. Whereas the red and the pink are my least favorite because they did not show up immediately. Like when you apply it, it's a little bit like, you know, it's going to be, look a little fade, and when it dries up is when the color actually starts to show. So when it's wet initially, you can't really see the color, so you might tend to mess up. Like I would say these are like buildable eyeliners. They are not in one swipe the full pigment like you would get with a black eyeliner, for example. So that was a little bit of a con for me, that the formulation is not consistent amongst all of the eyeliners. Like some are really good and really well pigmented, whereas some are not so well pigmented, and even if they are, they are going to take some time to show up. They are not going to immediately show up on your eyelid. That being said, once they dry up on your eyelid and once they are completely set in place, they are smudge proof and budge proof. They do not move at all. So while you're playing with them, you can, if you know, make any mistake, you can correct it while it's still wet, but once it's dried up, it's dried in place and you can't like really move them, which is great because then they won't bleed throughout the day. The fact that they don't transfer and that they are smudge proof is a total pro. But another con that I did identify is in some places they might look a little bit patchy, so they don't have a very even pigmentation. Like when you're applying it and once it's dried, it might not dry evenly throughout the eyeliner swipe. Like all throughout, you might not see one particular color. In some places, it might dry patchily. Once again, I feel like this also depends very strongly on the amount of water you're using. So if you use very little water, just a wet brush, then you might avoid the patchiness altogether. This is again something that I did not face with the yellow eyeliner. So once again, the yellow one is my most favorite. Now, another thing I wanted to point out is, like today, I have full glam makeup. I have set my eyelids with concealer and powder and then gone ahead with these eyeliners. So they look really pigmented and very pretty, and the colors are really popping, but I don't notice the same amount of pigmentation and the same amount of pop and vibrancy when you're using it bare lids. Like if you're not using any makeup and you're just going to apply it on your bare lid, I will be giving you all swatches of all of these eyeliners bare eyelids as well as with concealer and powder set in place, so you all will know what the difference is. I personally feel like they look much more vibrant when you have like a fully set eyelid as compared to if you're just applying it on a daily use. Now let's dive into each shade at a time. So the first shade I have for y'all is the red color. This is a nice vibrant red color. It's called Destroy, and this is the shade I personally had the most trouble working with because it sort of dried a little patchy, and in certain areas it looked very light and in certain areas it looked really dark when it dried up. So this particular shade is not my favorite. The next shade I have is Delicious. That is the yellow, bright yellow color. This is my personal favorite. I also have an affinity for yellow shades, but also this formula of this particular eyeshadow is bomb. It looks really good, stunning on the eyes. One swipe application, full pigmentation, does not dry patchy, and also looks good without any any base makeup on your eyes because it's a nice and vibrant color. I think because you have dusky hyperpigmented eyelids, this color's like lighter shades tend to show up more than the red and the pink, which is not so light. Like lighter shades are showing up better on brown skin is what I personally feel. From the very same family, we have these Strap, that is a neon orange color. Now this was not ideally supposed to belong to this bundle. I actually got a mess up and got these Strap in this bundle, but the logistics team reached out to me and they sent over the original shade as well, so they were very kind to do that. But this is a neon orange color, these Strap, and this also shows up really beautifully on the eyes. I think the lighter colors are just well formulated, not at all patchy, even though this is a neon color and I thought this would give me a hard time in showing up on my eyes and give me a hard time to just work with. This did not give me a hard time. It's a very well formulated eyeliner. It is easy to apply. It's just like the yellow, well pigmented, not patchy. And also again, this will also look stunning on your eyes without any base makeup on. And then we have the final shade right here, that is this hot pink color called Dessert. So this is a nice fuchsia hot pink, sort of a Barbie pink color. This is another color that gave me a hard time to work with. It took me a while to like get it to show, and for it, you know, to draw the wing and everything. It's not one swipe pigmentation. You will take some time to work with this color on your eyes. So bear that in mind when you're using this shade. And yeah, I think with that I complete everything that I had to say about the Define eyeliners from Debashree Beauty. Overall, in conclusion, I feel like it's a really good product with a lot of potential. It looks really beautiful and stunning on the eyes. It just takes some time for you to get used to how they are working and how you're supposed to use them. But once you get used to that, it becomes very simple and easy for you to work around with. Your hand will just set in place about how you're supposed to use it, how much water you're supposed to use, and all of that. And honestly, that much diversity in color is not really offered by any other brand for that matter. So because of that, I would definitely gravitate towards this brand if I'm looking for color cosmetics when it comes to India. So that's a great leap. But I genuinely feel like there's some inconsistency in the product formulation. Like, not all of the eyeliners are formulated exactly the same. Once again, color cosmetics is a little tricky when it comes to all of this, which is why I went into each shade individually, because I felt something different about every shade. So that was all for the four eyeliners that I had. Now let's dive into a mini tutorial of how I got this look. To begin with, I'm starting with the Define eyeliner in the shade Dessert, which is this pink color. Taking this on the brush and activating it with a little bit of water and trying to draw a wing with this eyeliner. I went from my middle two-thirds and then on the outer corner towards the wing. And then I went in with the shade Delicious, which is this yellow shade. Activated it with water and then went on the inner one-third of my eyelid so that I get like that ombre effect. This color is much more brighter and easier to work with, and then just meshed it in between on my eyelid. Then I took the Wet n Wild Kohl in the shade White and I went on my waterline with this. And then for mascara, I'm using the PAC Big Eyes mascara. I'm going to go over my top and bottom lashes with it. For my inner corner highlight, I'm taking this golden shade from the Yes Please palette from ColourPop. And then for my lower lash line, I'm going to take these two matte browns from the e.l.f. Mad for Matte palette. And I'm just going to smoke out my lower lash line. For my lips, I'm using the Milani lip liner in the shade Spice. I'm going to outline my lips with this. And then to fill my lips in, I'm using the Nykaa Mattelicious lip crayon in the shade Real Deal, which is a nice mauvey pink nude shade. And that's my look all complete. And with that, we complete today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed another episode of Sarah's Honest Review. If you did, then don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. And also let me know in the comments if y'all have purchased any of the Define eyeliners and if y'all have any other shades apart from these, and if they are also very well pigmented and I should grab my hands on this, then let me know in the comments. I would love to know and love to go ahead and buy them. Let me know which other product you all want me to review for the next episode of Sarah's Honest Review. For today's video, the Sarah Squad shout out goes to Garima Negi. Thank you so much for watching and supporting my channel. If you want to be a part of next video Sarah Squad shout out, then all you gotta do is hit the subscribe button, the bell icon right next to it, and also leave a comment down below saying hashtag Sarah Squad, and you get a chance to be a part of my next video Sarah Squad shout out. I will see you guys very soon in another video. Bye guys, take care, I love you.